Hi everyone, Ulysses here for Ask Our Experts. In this episode, we continue answering questions about motor control. And once again, we welcome back Pramit Nandy. So let's get into it. Pramit, there are several motor control applications which require a motor encoder. So what is the function of a motor encoder and where are they used?
Thank you, Ulysses. That's actually a very good question. So motor encoders are sensors which are giving feedback in terms of the motor position and the motor speed to the algorithm. For applications where initial torque requirement is very high, you want to use a sensored or a motor control or motor with an encoder in it, because that would give you the best overall torque response. For applications like electric vehicles, e-scooter, and some other applications where the initial torque requirement is much higher, you would use an encoder, right? That's the preferred way of doing it. Now, encoders can be of different types, right? They can be magnetic, inductive, optical, mechanical. So depending on what is the application and what kind of noise you can anticipate, you can choose the right one. In this video, I'll just walk you through a very simple optical encoder, as you can see in the diagram. So optical encoder is generating pulses. So there are two pulses, pulse A and pulse B. In some cases, there is also an index pulse, which is added to give more precise position of the rotor. So if pulse A is leading the pulse B, which are already in 90 degree with each other, so they are quadrature, so you can say that the motor is spinning in one direction. But in the other case, if pulse B is leading pulse A, that means the motor is rotating in another direction. Now, if you want to detect the speed, so number of pulse trains that you're going to receive in a given interval of time, that will give you an indication of what the RPM or speed of the motor is. So you get both the position of the rotor and you also get the speed, which are very important for complex algorithms like field-oriented control, which we reviewed in one of the videos in this series of videos.
Thank you, Pramit, for explaining the function of a motor encoder in motor control applications. Viewers, make sure to check out our application note, AN2757, linked in the description below for more info on this topic. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know when we have more insights from our experts. We'll see you next time.